All right, guys, this is a follow-up to the small little cam sensor leak on this corner. If you remember that, a lot of videos ago, a tiny piece of a video, we wouldn't really even be able to find it. And we had a little bit of seeping somewhere on the ground over down there somewhere. And just a couple days ago, I actually put a new O-ring in it. It was still seeping. I'd replaced the O-ring in that last video, whenever that was. And now I see with the bigger O-ring I tried, it almost looks worse. Like, you're better sticking with the regular O-ring. So I am gonna put this up in the air right now on the ramps, unbolt the bottom. We're gonna have a close-up look at this. There's definitely an oil leak here. Some people have mentioned the TSB for the leak in this general area. Now, what I think is, I think those are the cam position sensors, these big round ones that the TSB is on, not the one underneath that goes in with the magnet. I could be wrong. If I'm wrong, you show me the TSB, because I searched. I couldn't find one on that sensor. And my leak is definitely from the, see, I don't even know what, maybe you guys know, crank sensor. I don't know what that sensor is called that's leaking, because I haven't been that detailed in the engine itself like a lot of you guys, but it is not the front things. It's underneath. So I thought I'd call these cam sensors myself, and the one underneath the cam sensor. They can't all be cam sensors. So maybe the one underneath is a crank sensor. I don't think so. Best I know, this engine only has a crank in the middle. It doesn't have cranks on the edges. So let me pull it up here, and we'll take a look together. The leak does look worse, though. And, I mean, it's just an oil leak. Somehow it can be fixed. Just a matter of figuring it out. Maybe the sensor itself, as someone has said, is leaking. That's why the O-rings don't work. It looks like a pretty solid sensor. I don't see how oil can go through it, through the middle of it. It's a magnet block on the end. I'll show you. Hold on. Yeah, it's a pretty bad leak, guys. It may have been because I put way too big a O-ring in there. If you can see that, sort of. Almost a drip. Right there, you'll see, right above it, is the sensor we're talking about. Let me do the last two bolts and get this cover off. That's all dry. Oh man, it dripped right off the thing there. Yeah. That's exactly what it is. Exactly what it is. And you can see, because it comes right down off the radiator hose, drips to the radiator hose with a chain, and drips on the radiator hose. It's that piece up there. And I'm gonna, of course, pull this out, the sensor, one screw, and I'm gonna go ahead and is that it? Yeah, that's it. Right where we're looking at. Pull out that one screw, and maybe that O-ring I put in that was so big, maybe it like completely missed or split, and that would explain even more leak, as I was trying to fix a leak and I made the leak worse. So let me just get a quick 10 mil, bang it out, and we'll see. I'll see if I can get it out of there. Water's not gonna, oil isn't gonna gush out. It's not at the bottom of the engine. It's just a drip here and there when it's running, you know? All right, you can see in that connector itself, there's a lot of oil, but I do think it's coming from the seal and getting in here a little bit. It doesn't get, you know, past the orange seal in there. But, so I don't think it's coming out of the switch itself at all. I think it is coming out of whatever seal is between there and the block. Waiting for my screen to come up. If I can push this camera right up in the right spot. Oh, a little twist. Dang it, this stuff sucks. Oh, there, now I can swing this around. Is that it? Where is it? I can't even freaking tell, man. There. It's just basically the connection where it touches right where my finger is the crack where I think the oil is coming right out. Okay, let me pull out the seal and we'll take a look. Okay. Exactly. Good. I am happy with what I just found, guys. The O-ring was too big, which I tried to do to solve the issue. Bad idea. The O-ring broke, and I literally have a huge oil leak coming out of there. I'm glad I solved it. Now, all the weird color oil is a little bit concerning, but I don't think I have any coolant issues in this car, but that oil is a little bit strange in its coloration. Might be something I look into a bit. I could find that milky junk everywhere in my AOS system and all that, you know. And because I don't drive the car on long trips, I tend to get a lot of that sludge, as they call it. But I am happy that I found this O-ring right here. So the problem is explainable. That's the number one thing you always want. You want to, at least, even if you can't fix it right away or something, you always want to know, like, how is this occurring? This is a very clear, simple answer. It's occurring because I used too thick of a O-ring in there. I had to shove it in to the hole very hard. That's also what she said. And therefore, it disrupted that O-ring upon push-in, probably, and started leaking like hell ever since I thought I fixed it. Oh, wow. Leaking so much that it was down the J-pipe. Well, I'm glad that I saw something on the ground today and decided to take a look. That's a lot worse than just the O-ring that has a little leak. The small problem, I actually made it a much bigger problem when I changed that O-ring. So, you know, you don't always win them. You don't always get it right. In this case, I got it wrong. Put in a bigger O-ring. Too big an O-ring. I definitely do not think, I'm going to spray it out, of course. Let's take a look at the sensor real quick. I do not think for 1 second that the sensor itself is leaking. It's almost impossible. It is sealed. There is no way that oil is getting through the sensor. It's a solid block and out the tab. So it's the O-ring issue. That's what it is. I'm going to have to order factory O-rings, I guess. I got all these O-ring boxes from all these fancy places, and maybe they just don't work well, and you do need the factory O-ring, and that's a waste of money to get all those aftermarket O-rings. You'd think they'd work. I don't know. I'm sure one of my green aftermarkets will work a lot better than a ripped one for now. But I'll probably hop on Subaru's site, find the O-ring part. I could use your help on all that, guys. I mean, there's so many pages. It takes me forever to find Subaru parts. If someone hops on there, tries to find this piece, you know exactly where it is. And if they sell the O-ring on it, I mean, with 17,000 subscribers wide, I'm sure someone can find it pretty quick for me that does this all the time. Whenever I got to find one little part for the car, you know, you got to look through all those different diagrams, and it's all placed weird, some of the stuff. It's hard to find. So I'm going to do a temp fix. I'm not really going to record much else. I'm just going to be putting a better fit O-ring on the thing. You know, cleaning up a little bit. Like, that's a perfect fit for my finger. Yeah, that is what she said. All right. Oh, perfect fit. So snug. All right. I just cleaned it off. Get you a bango close up. And I'm going to go ahead and find an O-ring, put it in. I am going to spray out this connector piece, which is probably oily. And I don't want to get mixed results with some of the oil in there coming out and tricking me, making me think it's still real bad. But I do need to find a factory O-ring, I guess. I don't trust the aftermarket O-rings on this. What the fuck, man? Disgusting. I'm gonna have to get rid of that later. I don't want that crap in my yard. All right, look at this beauty in here, guys. Look at the beauty of satisfaction, of instrumentation. That's just quality there. That's just parts upon parts upon parts. Man, it'd be fun to bring this car back stock. It really would. It'd be such a challenge. All the bolts would strip out. I've been rethinking a header because I have absolutely nothing to do, but oh my God, that would require the J-pipe coming off everything. I'd probably strip out half of the J-pipe bolts. I'd regret it immediately getting into that job. I don't know. All right, that's the leak job for now, guys. Having some tough luck on this car. I'm going to get it taken care of, and I'll see you guys next time. It's probably just me that has that leak, but, you know, take a look next time you're under the car. You never know.